Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of Space Station Live this Wednesday, April 17. Today, Commander Hadfield and Flight Engineer Marshburn continue to follow a special diet and log their diet consumption as part of a couple of human body studies, ProK and Energy. Hadfield also had set up a continuous blood pressure device, donned leg arm cuffs, and worked with the pulmonary function system rebreathing protocol for a periodic checkup for another human body study that looks at long-duration crew members' pulmonary function. Hadfield also tended to the ongoing research of a binary colloidal alloy test, or BCAT, checking out the camera system that monitors its operations. He then also performed a water analysis today using the total organic carbon analyzer of the water processor assembly from the water recovery system. The system converts urine, sweat, and condensation into drinkable water for the crew. Commander Hadfield and Flight Engineers Marshburn and Cassidy also took time to talk to kindergarten through 12th grade students and their teachers at the Fernbank Science Center in Atlanta, Georgia, for Destination Station, which is a traveling exhibit that showcases life, work, and science aboard the space station. Today, Marshburn worked much of his morning loading software to an express rack that provides science experiments with standard utilities such as power, data, cooling, fluid, and gases. He then also loaded the payload software to two of the onboard Merlin incubators in the Glacier, both of which are part of the cold stowage fleet of hardware that are compatible with the express racks and store science experiment samples that require refrigeration. And Flight Engineer Chris Cassidy set up the robotics workstation today to review and monitor today's walk-off of the space station robotic arm. The robotic ground controllers at Mission Control Houston will maneuver the Canada Arm 2 for a base change from the power and data grapple fixture on the Harmony module to the mobile base system. And on the Russian side of the house, Vinogradov and Romanenko donned their Orlan spacesuits once again today for a suited dry run dress rehearsal for the procedures they will conduct during Friday's scheduled spacewalk just outside the pier's docking compartment airlock. The spacewalk is scheduled to begin Friday around 9:06 a.m. Central Time and is scheduled to last 6 hours as Vinogradov and Romanenko deploy and retrieve experiments on the Russian segment of the station, and also replace a faulty reflector device on the aft end of the Zvezda service module that is part of the navigational aids to be used for the automated docking of the European Space Agency's Albert Einstein, the automated transfer vehicle for cargo ship, Zvezda, later in June. Meanwhile, back on Earth, NASA is poised and ready for its test launch of the Orbital Sciences Antares rocket from the Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia. Launch is scheduled at 4 p.m. Central Time. We'll have live coverage of that launch that will set the stage for sending a new commercial cargo ship to the International Space Station beginning here at 3 p.m. Central Time.